vamos, 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 vamos. Nice, nice. Stay alive, stay. Play me, play me, play me. Play me, play me. I'm blocking this. Nice, nice. Stay alive, stay alive. You're insane!
Hola bros, ¿cómo están? El día de ayer se jugó la Apex Legends Global Series Championship, que es el mundial de Apex Legends para la región de Norteamérica. Esto generó algunas controversias, algunas opiniones divididas, pero antes de empezar con este video quiero explicarles un poquito de cuál fue el formato de este torneo para darles un poquito de información acerca de esto. Recuerden que próximamente estaré subiendo un video explicando detalladamente cómo funcionan los torneos de Apex Legends, cómo funcionan las clasificaciones y qué diferentes tipos de torneos podemos encontrarnos en la escena de Apex. Así que si no estás suscrito, por favor te invito a que lo hagas para que estés al pendiente de esta información. Pero bueno, el día de ayer, como les comentaba, se jugó esta final. Teníamos la participación de 20 equipos que estaban luchando por el mayor o la mayor cantidad de premios en la historia de este torneo. Estos equipos pues tenían 3 jugadores para dar un total de 60 jugadores que estaban buscando este premio. Lo más importante es que este torneo se jugó con un formato diferente al que habitualmente estamos acostumbrados a ver en este tipo de torneos. El formato normal o el formato más común es que se juegan un total de 6 partidas y el que tenga más puntos que todos, el que quede en el primer lugar en cuanto a puntos por posición sumados a los puntos por kills, es el ganador. Pero en este torneo fue diferente y el formato que se utilizó se llama formato de match point. Este formato básicamente es que en cuanto un equipo consiga 50 puntos o superior a 50 puntos, este equipo entra en una etapa que se llama match point. Después de haber obtenido estos 50 puntos en la partida siguiente o en las partidas siguientes, si consigue o si conseguía la win, se hacía el campeón automáticamente del torneo. No había un número de partidas específico, sino que las partidas podían alargarse hasta que uno de los equipos que tenía más de 50 puntos y que estaba en fase de match point ganara y ganara el torneo de esta manera. Esto, como les decía, generó algunas polémicas porque no es específicamente muy justo, pero sí que le ayuda muchísimo al espectáculo que tuvo el torneo.
Lo único que hace es rankear.
24 points just behind them, ESA Black on 21. There are two teams who have won games so far, but only a point or two separating every single team on the way down. Dan, so you mentioned that pop off game. One of those right here, you can propel yourself right up the leaderboards. Even a team like My Little Phony, down at the bottom right now,
they're on 3
points. As crazy as it sounds, it's only 21 points behind. And we saw games like that yesterday.
No, la neta, caer en Skyhook estaría muy feo. No sé dónde caeríamos.
If we see a pop-off game, we could see a team.
Porque están cayendo.
That's what's happened when you get
prácticamente dos equipos ahí, güey. No solo que caigamos hasta el fondo, no están cayendo ellos, pero no vamos a tener casi
loot. No sé, está difícil. But actually, a 14 kill game with a victory would achieve that, and we have seen games like that throughout ALGS history, so I will not put it as an impossible thing to do so. We had a brief glimpse of where that circle was going to go on your screens, and it is going to be southeast, down towards Dome, down towards Lava City, and slightly covering Sorting Factory as well. So fantastic for those teams who are dropping down there. And six after the game that he had previously.
¿Cuántas partidas faltan? No se sabe, bro. No, no es por partidas.
Some of those teams are going to have to make that short journey. It's another zone on the eastern side of the map, even though it's right down on the south side.
And uy, güey, va a cerrar donde está Prodi.
Esports Arena Black, they're down there in Dome at the moment. And Esports Arena White, they drop over at Geyser. So
creo que cierra con ellos, güey. Güey, qué suerte, güey.
Esports Arena Red to win one.
Qué suerte, güey.
That might be the chance for ESA because they drop over at Lava City, so
a great zone for them. La voy a dar rápido.
Yeah, they do really control the southeast side of the map, but they're not going to be teaming. They, of course, may be under the same sort of organization, but entirely different sponsors and entirely different
sponsors. Sniper era de Rogue, sí.
Gunning for that first place and will take no mercy, equipo. No matter who is in their way. But this is going to be difficult for rotations for those who are dropping the likes of Trials, the likes of Skyhook, but this is where the Valkyries become very important. Try and get into those spots very early, but this is not an easy circle to predict. Sometimes you'll see ones that are slightly more over Lava City or slightly more over Dome, slightly more over Sorting. It's going to be hard to try and bank on where there's going to be, maybe just outside launch site.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting circle for sure, and those teams who have knowledge are going to be in a great advantageous position. If they do know one of those funky pools and they've played these zones 1,000 times before and they can set up for it, they might have a real opportunity. But My Little Phony, who have had a little bit of a rough start so far, well, they're in a fight early on here over at Refinery. If they could win this, maybe a little bit of confidence restore. But Rambo at the moment, you can see, trying to be aggressive on that Revenant.
Pito,
and that
one
jumping over to Fury, but he's being shot in the back now. He's exchanging some shots now with the Peacekeeper and the R9.
I'm loving the bait and switch I'm seeing from My Little Phony. Just drop, pop one shot, hide again, reshield, get those shields back up, and then you re-engage and try and reignite the other team. But neither team at the moment really wanting to push in, both reluctant to get too much into a skirmish, maybe feeling like they could be third-partied if they get into a elongated fight here. So instead, backing off, repositioning,
and My Little Phony definitely have the high ground.
They're trying to just hold this team inside of the building, but it's very difficult to push a team.
No sé,
if you
bueno,
do have
creo.
The high ground, especially when you've got Kotogami playing that caustic as well. So you're going to see some shots exchanged, and it looks like we're going to see a little bit of a temporary truce here. But as I say,
sombras,
that, here comes the Revenant push, the totem being used, and that's going to deal some damage. The question is, are the rest of the team close enough
no,
to
ya, bajándoles a uno y no, GG, bros.
Is absolutely massive. That Ay, is going to open
wey.
The door now for them to wipe the squad.
Qué asco,
Rambeu,
¿por qué eres así, güey?
Trying to stay alive.
And this is why they just elongated that fight. Wait for that Revenant to have the ultimate and then re-engage. Get the wipe, get the 3KP. And My Little Phony very much deservedly winning that fight after their patience, after going for the
wey, me da coraje ver, me da coraje, güey, que la gente use Revenant en torneo, güey.
Composition changes
porque se siente bien culero
13,
cuando
Liquid,
te matan así
switched,
de que una mega ventaja, güey.
Kind of in and out as we get further into this
una mega ventaja en el 3
like
contra 3
adjusting as we go on and just kind of recognizing what else is in the lobby.
Well, G2, had some pretty
no nada más en el 3 contra 3, güey, o sea, para hacer party. Imagínate, tú puedes llegar bien tranqui, güey, bajas a mínimo uno, güey. Mínimo uno bajas.
And we've seen examples of how good they are in those team fight situations. It's going to be an interesting zone for me to watch. I think what side
es que a mí, o sea, a mí sí me emputaría, si me emputa, güey, o me emputaría si me hicieran eso, güey, con Revenant.
Where it's going to be going is towards Dome, as you can see now, NRG working their way around the backside of Dome, of course, moving around from the southwestern side of World's Edge from their drop over at staging. And you can always kind of guess with NRG wherever they start to move, that's where the zone is going to end up.
Ojalá quiten al revés, pues no sé, güey, lo que tenga que pasar.
Be a position that a lot of these teams are going to be playing as well as Dome side. It can pull either side of the mountain, as you say. Another reason why Valkyrie can be
¿dónde puedo encontrar clips tuyos?
En mi
TikTok, en mi Facebook, en mi página de Facebook. Aquí en el mismo canal, pero está más difícil.
We have seen finishes just under tracks as well outside of sorting. There are a lot of elevated positions you can play and you almost become a tiered birthday cake. You have one team on top, one team in the middle and one team down low if it's going to be one of those circles. And they're always enjoyable to watch.
We're going to have to see how it does play out. And I think a lot of teams are wondering how this is going to play out. That zone 3
information
is going to be absolutely vital. If anyone manages to hit a beacon
pues
on their way in one of those slightly later rotating teams or maybe just a team who has control of one of those buildings with the beacon on it, is going to have some vital, vital information to play with. We can see where Renegades are set up at the moment. Renegades with a pretty good start so far. 21 points on the board for them. They're currently tied for second place as far as points is concerned with ESA Black. So Renegades, a team who just managed to squeak into our final lobby, have had a pretty good start here, Dan.
Wait, well, te ando viendo más a ti que la final, viejo sabroso.
Let's jump into a listen in with Renegades.
Yeah, pónganse a ver la final, bros. Watching.
I got my blue.
El de el Nathan está prendido, bros. Como que van a quitar zona. Anda peleando G2 contra NRG, si no me equivoco.
Yeah, I know.
Si no me equivoco. No. Es que no alcanzo a ver los nombres, güey. Creo sí, NRG contra G2. NRG contra G2. No, ya no. No se van a matar. No se están matando, solo están rotando. Pero puede que me la serien a NRG. Que diga a G2. Uy, van. Ya gastaron cúpula. Güey, ponle otra pelea, hijo.
Yeah, it is wild. Yeah, I'm looking. I don't know what's going on. I just see Gibby ult and the bubble in the open.
Era TSM contra Liquid, la predicción.
Well, a little bit
sí
of a quiet conversation there, Dan. But you can see in the picture at the moment, there's a massive fight going down. And that fight is between NRG and G2. They are desperate to fight for the ground that's being held. G2 having a backup for now. NRG controlling the inside of the building.
Yeah, G2 just kind of gatekeeping a little bit at the moment. Just... Well, both teams really desperately wanting to get into it, but you can play
los
in the red as
verga
much
en lugar
as you want.
Like,
you've got a lot of heals, you've got the position.
Estos güeyes los de NRG los
be
están
a little
cazando,
bit patient
eh.
Here, but the further you do push in, the more likely you're going to run into NRG just gatekeeping you. So G2 struggling a little bit, but they need to decide when they want to pounce.
G2 using that ultimate accelerant as well.
Uy, ya se enojó. Ay, ¿por qué se van, güey?
I love this decision making here from Sweet. This isn't just big thinking from them. This is defending a position.
Wey, ¿por qué se van, güey?
G2 use that ultimate, which is then gonna not be able to be used a little bit later on, and you can see Designful and Resulta a little bit of confusion caused by this rotation
sandwich
from NRG as they now have to back up and find themselves in a position.
Ah, es que está el blog con enojado, güey, es muy difícil matarlo, güey. Se mueve súper rapidísimo.
Make sure they can reset those health points and those heals, of course, as now we are going to see.
A mí siempre me
uy,
Imperial. Matando al equipo de Rambi. Mátenlos, güey, a la verga, güey. Llámanlos a lobby.
Yeah, TSM just trying to assert their dominance just on the outer side of this ring at the moment.
Gracias, Ernest, por los 8 mesecitos. Saluditos, bro.
Difficult when you're going up against a Revenant team because of the silence, but they will be more than happy.
Mátalo, mátalo, Snipedown. Pusheale como toro, güey.
You know when he wants a kill, he's gonna hunt those
a la verga,
down,
el Revenant.
And hunt them down he does. Rambo will be the second player to fall, and it looks like TSM are
mátalo,
güey.
Con piedad, güey, esos perros.
No,
abre la puerta.
They will be able, you would imagine, to reset inside of that building. Luckily, that door was open at just the right time. As now Reps will be brought back to his feet, as well as Snipedown. I should say, excuse me, how will be brought
bueno,
back to his feet, as well as Snipedown.
Solo,
and all the players probably
wanted
to alive with two teammates down. It was going to be Reps on the Gibraltar to get that
Liquid,
down and get that quick res off. But now Team Liquid, with that change to the composition that you mentioned a few moments ago.
Oh, sí es cierto que Liquid cambió de leyendas, ¿eh?
Yeah, so they've always got the backup option of using the Valkyrie Caustic, if they want, but at the moment they're kind of
Gibby
shadowing the initial engagement we saw between G2 and NRG. So if there was to be a full-on 3v3 scuffle, suddenly
Valky
Liquid could get involved, but they're being griefed right now. And now this is where you can use the Valkyrie. You bubble up, you attach, and you get yourself into circle, and you hope
Old,
but Sweet with the shots with the flatline denies the ultimate.
I think half the lobby just took down Avril Ellie. Somehow they managed to get the res off though.
Eso fue grave.
In position to capitalize or wanting to take the risk, but saying that there's one player.
Adios,
that does,
Liquid, señores.
And his name is Nathan. He's going to move behind Liquid. He's going to finish off one. G2 also involved as well, and Liquid just caught in a horrible position.
¿Cómo lo mataron, güey? ¿Con un Kraven o qué? No, pues no traen Kraven.
Just left the rest of the team to fall.
And maybe they just didn't know they were shadowing the likes of NRG and
G2,
so close
wey
to being able to pop
ahí
off
anda
that ultimate, get out of dodge, but the likelihood is
pararon,
even if they
creo
got up to the air,
creo
the shots of some of these players, you can still destroy any Valkyrie sailing through
ya
the sky.
Cúpula,
and now the final
no,
remaining
Liquid,
player desperately
señores
trying to scarper
sí,
away and stay alive, G2 getting involved as Nathan and Rocker managed to get the downs, and honestly, Liquid are just hoping they can survive right now.
Liquid are in shambles. However, Liquid
nosotros
still
NRG,
alive.
We're
and that is massive.
We're
and you can see the NRG, they want to take advantage of it. They want to make sure
uy,
that
no
Liquid isn't going to be part of this game
a,
for much longer. They're going to be
la,
taking a lot of damage from
Relini
the zone as well. You have to question if they're going to be able to get any kind of position. But
les quieren hacer como sandwich
G2
a los de NRG.
Both NRG could not take out Liquid. Liquid on life support,
están haciendo tiempo, güey, pero ahorita otra vez usa la Valkyria y se va a pelar Liquid. Se va a pelar Liquid, señores. Están haciendo tiempo. ¡Uy, yo voy a Nathan! ¡Pendejazos, güey!
Güey,
corre, pushen, pushen. Adiós, NRG, güey. Top 18 con 0 kills.
And that is a massive, massive story to follow. I mean, just everything.
Wait, vivió Liquid, señores.
Also in a little bit of trouble. Retzi may go down to a slither of health, but at least Senok's been able to heal up here, can do the damage onto Hill. So
Alpine in a fight with Senok. Por andar de hambriados, güey. Lo que les pasó, güey.
Advantage in this skirmish.
Yeah, Senok once again showing what a danger he is to anyone in this lobby. The massive shots hit hard, and he has been really performing strongly for Sentinels in individual fights recently. A man to certainly watch.
Oh, mira, Liquid se vivió. Ya viene la ulti, el Aurelini, güey.
Liquid from a shambles have somehow managed to find their way inside of the zone. Liquid will not die. They're like a zombie in the lobby at the moment.
Like a phoenix from the ashes, Liquid now getting involved. Qué buena, now Pirelli will fall, but Nocturnal and Flanker are there to clean up the
pobrecita, güey, ¿vieron? Oh, Belgibi, pobrecito, güey, bien tranqui viendo por la ventana y huevos por la espalda, güey, a la verga, abuelo.
Liquid are alive, and that is all you need to know. With the momentum they're going to have, not just from managing to survive, but then managing to turn it into KP, it's going to be huge for them towards the end of this game. But why all of that carnage
no se sabe cuántas partidas son, bro.
A little bit of calm is starting to establish yourself over
Lava City.
Lots of teams stacked up on top of each other, but none of them engaging
vivo,
with
creo.
Each other right now. Obey Alliance on that tracks that we talked about a little
es
bit ago.
Es que va a ahí donde ellos
you
estaban.
Talked about how this becomes a little bit of a birthday cake towards the end game. If we do see the shift there, you're going to see teams playing below and above where they're currently positioned.
Ah, en el túnel. Okay.
On another POV, we have seen where that next circle is going to be going, and just the kind of vault area on the west side of Lava City is where this final
pizza,
circle is going
no
to be residing. So it's a really, really tough spot for a lot of these teams to play. But right now,
no,
Sentinels
pues
want to try and pick up some KP here, but have to be careful because they are in the center of a lot of action.
They want to go forward. They want to get kills. CLG are going to be involved, though. You can see Lou and Madness with both a scout and a 301 are going to pick up some kills for CLG, who need a little bit momentum themselves.
Ah, ok, bros, ok. Adiós, Rambi, güey. Ah, chinga, Rambi no estaba muerto. Lo pararon, yo creo. Adiós, adiós, Aurelini, bros.
Still in a lot of trouble, despite the fact they were able to come back from what seemed like an impossible situation.
Bajón, Aurelini,
Sentinels can kind of calm down a little bit, but look at this. All these teams trying to
los de Uris ya están muertos, güey, son dos.
Trying to get closer towards this end circle that was in the picture-in-picture for a brief second. It is not going to be easy for those teams who did predict the other side of the mountain. G2 might get some KP here,
uy,
and
casi.
That's going to be Alpine taken out of the gentrifying, just picking up that one, but the teams who did predict Lava City on set, they're
going to be los de
right
Liquid,
now.
Señores.
Eso
que son volando, que están volando son los de Liquid.
I wonder if his teammate's going to be there in order to get the revive. It looks like no, look at the kill feed right now. RKN taken down, which means that Alpine will be down to just one player. G2 making their move.
Eso les pasa por
the edge of zone here. They're going to be approaching from the north, but they're still teams.
Ojito, Liquid, ¿dónde cayó, señores? Ya tienen toda la zona. Tienen toda la zona.
It's almost poetic in the way that they are staying alive, and now they have the top of the three-story building, one of the strongest positions they
can wish for. Liquid agarró la mejor zona.
Probably can't believe this themselves that they've managed to get to this position, but
bestia,
arguably
wey.
One of the best spots in the game right now.
Señores, perro.
Pushing out from the edge of the circle, and they are above everyone else in this three-story building. It's going to be a case of whatever. Someone has some confidence to push them on top, but you know, I don't think people will. I probably wouldn't want to go against Liquid right now.
And if you know Aurelele, you'll know he'll be getting hyped in these moments as well. Big games make big players.
Wey, qué buena
big
zona agarraron estos morros, wey.
Like
Aurelele
when the tough moments approach. Now Flank are going to be moving with him. They're going to be barreling up with that core stick as well. And now you're going to see Sentinels involved as well. And all of
no,
the teams, all of these big
morir.
Names in the lobby starting to hit shots now in game 3. You can really tell there's a feel
Sentinel
of a massive
muere,
grand finals performance.
Sentinel muere en rotación.
And there's just so many engagements taking place because so many teams
Imperial.
Haven't been able to get
Imperial
center zone. They
haven't
been able
to get contra
into
Sentinel.
A safe position. You've either got to go through the vault or you've got to go round the mountain. And either way,
tienen que matar
you're
a Sentinel,
going to be gate kept by teams.
Bueno.
TSM are one of those teams gatekeeping right now, and they should be able to farm all these players.
Pégale, sniper, pégale. De si G2 está muerto ya. Acaban de matar a G2. Ya Sentinel murió. Sentinel murió.
Already inside of Lava City, and there is the move behind them. Although it looks like TSM have managed to get a little bit of a head glitch here, which is going to make taking them down difficult.
No, es una interesting rotation here
from TSM, but one is looking extremely effective
for now.
They're going to be forced to bubble though, and that might.
Ya, esto les va a dar tiempo, pero creo tienen que matar a ese equipo, güey. Si no, si no, anda, si los tienen que matar ya, güey. Ya. Ah, 0-1.
Nice.
Güey, Liquid está hasta arriba, señores.
Fantastic spot right now.
Liquid looking so so strong.
Yo pensé que Liquid los iban a matar, güey. Es un principio. Pero se está rifando.
Let's jump into a listen in and see how they play this out.
La va a sacar TSM.
How much
lighter
mode do you have, Max?
Cost the call out 300.
Give me 60.
No sé si puedes.
Cost the call out.
No sé si la saquen, güey.
I'm trying to look to break it. Right here. I don't see it.
Tienen zona ahí, pero.
Top priority. I think we default stairs right now. Top. Do not overextend.
Tom, yeah. Look on north and west, Brandon. Stay
south is looking to push us. South is looking.
Focus on south. I'm holding stairs. Okay, you let us know if you need us. Yep. Tom, keep looking for kills on north northwest. Because you're gonna have rotations on the north end or on the west end actually. Tunnel is kills.
There's an Octane looking south for us. There's an Octane looking south. I'm gonna.
No mames.
Okay, this is weird.
Looking west.
Con la ulti de Gibby.
30 on Valk.
Uy, van a aplicar la misma, güey. Le van a aplicar la misma.
Le
van a aplicar la misma.
Play
wide, because if they have caustic, they do what we just did.
Okay.
We already have bubble on me, Brandon.
Yeah. Heard.
They have caustic. Give me 70.
Caustic.
Bubble on me.
Crack Gibby. Bubbling on me. Get ready for the fight.
I'm gonna gas their outside if they land on the roof.
Yes.
Verga, ¿ahora qué, güey? Si les pusieron cúpula, ¿qué?
¡Play on me! ¡Play on the height! ¡Play on the height!
¡No! ¡No!
They bubbed.
Play me.
Gas.
I'm getting them out. I used gas nade on them. They bubbed.
Ya, güey. Liquid está muerto, bros.
I'm gassing them. I'm healing.
Play my shield. Play my knockdown. Another Gibby ult. Sí, güey. Above us.
Drop, Tom. Just play your life and drop.
Bien tranqui, güey. Güey, bien tranqui ese vato. No. Prodigy sigue vivo, señores. Por ahí vi. Güey. Es que hicieron mierda a este güey. Al Gibby.
And TSM also in the kill feed, continuing to slay out here.
Llegó mi pizza, fuck.
Would have been so important if they could have taken Valk out the sky, but we can see how important Valkyrie can be to just taking one of the dominant positions on this map. But TSM still in a fantastic spot, kill leaders at the moment as well. And here comes the jump pad. They're making their move, but they're going to be moving into a lot of players here.
TSM just trying to get as close as possible to the action. Some shots from Snipe Down are going to connect. However, there's going to be shots exchanged. But how has his back? As now, unfortunately, Snipe Down will fall from a team from above, and now it's down to Refs and Imperial Howl to hold it down here for TSM.
I like the thought about going for the bubble, going for the res, but you need to just recognize when you cannot pick a man up, as now the ultimate start to rain down. The players are stacked in this building. One player's out on his own in the bubble, and TSM have spotted him. This is potentially 3 KP for whoever can finish it, and TSM managed to get the last player.
Oh, that is a poor, poor move for Gibby. Unfortunately, he had nowhere to go, and it will be knocked. He was the last player alive there for C9, who will go down to the hands of TSM. They have control of the outside of the building. Kangana up on the top of the building as well. Space Station in the end game too. 5 squads remaining here as we might see Snipe Down brought back into the action to have a little bit of a say in how this game finishes.
Respawn beacons can be absolutely massive in the end game, and of course you drop with shields now, you can pick up your loot, and every team is going to be trying to drill you, but if he can get to his box, if he can armor swap, get those weapons, that could be absolutely massive, as now teams are starting to move towards the circle because this building is not going to be in.
Reps just waiting
for the drop. How doing likewise. Shots coming down from above. They're going to be exchanged. They're going to be caught in a caustic gas
mess
at the moment. But TSM kind of just watching everything go down. How managed to get a stick there onto Bronzy as well as now letter E.
Wait, this move. Imperial
goes down. The ultimate goes down from the caustic. Keeping our eye on the feed as
no more Imperial way.
Snipe down is brought back into the game. He's only got an heirloom to work with, but Snipe down still trying to do what he can do.
He got two kills with the heirloom, but he's gonna go down, and the rest
of them
is all down.
The winner.
Reps goes off. What am I just
seeing?
What did Reps just do?
¿Qué hizo? Wait, chúpense la bros. Wow, chúpense la güey.
To
bring
it back, Snipe down just punching his way
through
the lobby as he arrives late in
la
the shot.
Jugada, TSM wey, del torneo.
Out of absolutely nowhere. That was fantastic.
Absolutely ridiculous.
La jugada del torneo.
Ridiculous from TSM. And if anyone was counting them out before
a
this tournament
bestia,
got underway,
wey.
Well, what else do I have to say? A monstrous, monstrous game from TSM. And, I mean, Reps. Massive in the end.
Play me. I'm blocking this. Nice, stay alive! You're insane!
I am fucking insane!
Good job, Jordan! Holy shit!
Fucking bro!
Holy shit!
Fucking down two people meleeing them!
You don't even know what I just fucking did!
Oh my fuck! God. Yeah, baby! Caustic! Oh my god! Oh! No fucking way! No fucking way! Oh my god!
I didn't realize there was this little overhang of the balcony.
I think, okay, next time we do that, I think we looked it through the fourth floor.
Okay.
Instead of just, like, defaulting the roof, we just play fourth floor.
I agree.
Because that,
we can push teams out when we have Toxic. If it comes down to whether Tom wins the 1v1 against Toxic or not.
Snipe is meleeing. Okay.
Snipe got respawned.
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying, like, he just meleeed and killed that guy, which is really funny. Yeah, okay.
Oh my god,
that,
Jordan
just,
is daddy. Oh my god,
lesson,
Jordan just won
like,
that.
Next time we do that.
Fuck, there's no way Jordan just won
you
that.
You see that?
Holy shit. It? Yeah, Jordan just won that with 1 HP and a 1v4.
Just by punching people.
Do you have any names?
Could this be the Twitter clip? Will we be seeing you on Twitter? Oh my god, storm coming in. Mobile beacon down. Is someone sticking it? How's sticking it right now?
Sticking it. Watch the front door.
Oh my god. Snipe Down's gonna be back in. He's not gonna have loot, but it will be an extra body for TSM to work with.
You just have to live here, son.
Octane pad going down as caustic gas comes in.
Say.
Hal arc starring the right side with some arc stars. That's how it works. And he got the knock on Bronzy. He finds another knock on Frex. Hal going crazy. Bubble fight going down right now. Caustic playing his life inside. Another team comes in. Almost finds an outlaw, if he doesn't find it, Snipe Down playing his life, Reps playing his life.
Stay alive, stay alive, play me, I'm blocking this.
Snipe Down goes down, Reps last one alive, 28 feet, trying to stay alive, can he do it? I don't know how he's still alive.
Stay alive.
You're insane! No fucking way!
I am
no fucking way!
I am